오빤 강남 스타일. 강남 스타일. 오빤 강남 스타일. No. No.
It only comes once a year, and it's called the Portland Retro Gaming Expo.
So, third year at the PRGE, it's pretty sweet. We got to see some old friends, some new friends.
Hey, you're those game brother guys, right?
We went, of course, with Tyler, Super Tie Gamer, Andrew.
Girl, gone too far, cause you know it don't matter anyway.
And Derek obviously went too, yeah. No one cares about him.
This year, what did we do? Well, we got up at the early a.m.
We decided that we were going to get there bright and early, early entry, right at 9 o'clock. We were going to be there. We arrive at the convention center around 8:20, 8:30, somewhere around there, and we walk in. There's a line to get tickets. So we're like, well, okay, it's not too bad. The line wasn't too long. So we get our tickets, and we turn over, and we just look around. And there is a giant line of people, like, going all the way across the convention center. And we're just like, are you kidding me? And keep in mind, we got there, like, a half an hour early. Like, we weren't late by any means. Like, you know, there was still a good amount of time before the doors were going to open. And we're just like, wow, this is insane.
Holy shit. That was a pretty long line.
So we're standing in line. Of course, Tyler, being the music guy he is, pulls out his phone, gets on Spotify. He starts playing songs like a full blast, like just embarrassing us.
Frickin' Tyler decided to embarrass the hell out of all of us by playing Stairway to Heaven in the middle of the line. And he started singing to it. And then I started singing to it also.
She blows, it goes on and on and on.
Kyle, film you filming me.
The thing is, like,
I don't even know the lyrics to the song, but I was like, they're like singing it. I'm just like,
damn.
Whatever. On the ball. She wants to be sure that she knows sometimes starts have no meaning.
So yeah, that was interesting. So the line starts moving, and then it stops. And it stops about right before the first escalator we went up, so we were only about 50 feet away from the doors. And we see Tyler walking around with Wood from Beat 'Em Ups, and they're just walking around. And they had already been in the show for hours because their vendor's there.
Tyler comes by with Wood from Beat 'Em Ups, and we just looked at him in jealousy, and they just kept going, and they said, we're vendors. And they just walked on right by, and I knew at that moment that they had already gained access to the showroom about the day before, which, well, that's obvious. But yeah, evidently they had already scavenged everything, so says Tyler. I kind of hope they didn't, because there were probably some pretty good things there.
Oh, come back! Yes, the good people! Wait, no! VIP! We do it here! Tyler! Tyler! God!
Oh, hey, there's Metal Jesus, what do you know?
There's Metal Jesus!
I said it first. Wow, thanks.
Gonna build our way up to
not,
there.
Are we not cool, Tyler?
We're well, not, I'm getting into that status right now.
We're not closely related enough. We're friends with the guy that knows the cool guys, so we can't like.
I'm friends with Jared.
Tyler, let us be with you.
I mean,
please.
If you're watching this video, you have failed us.
No more.
for
him. I am going to help at your vendor booth next year. It will happen.
I am going to get all the good retro YouTubers. It will be mine. One day.
Just pass by. One day. Like, not even say anything.
So we can finally see the doors. We're finally about to walk in. We get our swag, and we walk in. Our swaggy bags here. Look at this swaggy bag. Swag bag. That's what I'm calling it now.
When the doors open, the lights of heaven shine down onto us. And we heard Wii Shop music. It was a beautiful moment.
It's a Wii Shop music. Yes.
Where is he?
That's so much
Where
better
is he? Music. All right, let's stop walking here. In. You know, the sheer amount of vendors and arcade machines and all that didn't really shock me as much as having the shock of not knowing what games to look for, because there are so many games at these expos that you just don't even know what to start looking for. You're seeing all these games you want to get, and you just don't have all the money to buy all these games, and you got to prioritize, and you got to look around, and, you know, you may walk around once and be like, oh, okay, I'm going to make sure I come back to see if I can get that game. And then the next time you walk around, it's gone.
So I was like the main navigator this time around, and they were asking me, oh, where should we go? And I'm like, hey, can I check out the Nintendo Doctor's booth and see if he has a boxed copy of Conker's Bad Fur Day? And they're all like, sure, sure. So, you know, I kept walking forward. I was like, hey, guys, it's right around this. Where the hell did they go? They just disappeared. They were like little children in a freaking Toys R Us.
Okay, for Derek, we're going to 140. Retro Game Trader.
Wait a minute.
Retro Game Trader.
You know, we walk around a couple times just kind of scouting out what games are where and, you know, what booths have, you know, different pricing and to see if, you know, we can find doubles of games that are cheaper other places. And I walk around, and I didn't really buy anything for the first hour or two. I was just, like, so overwhelmed by what to look for, like I said. So, you know, after a while of walking and getting footage of booths and arcade machines and all that, Andrew and I decide to rest for a little bit. And he tells me he bought me a game. And I'm kind of like, oh, great. Is it going to be a crappy game? Although, the day before, he had told me, I don't think I'm going to buy you a crappy game, because that would just be cliche. But he owed me for some Steam games that I had bought him, and he owed me for some other stuff, so he went ahead and decided to give me a gift. And I guess I'm thankful, and I'm not really sure what to think. But he pulls me aside, and we're sitting down, and he tells me he got this game for me, and he's like, oh, don't look. He's like, okay, actually, you know what? Just look in this bag. It's the first thing in the bag. So, what does he get me? He gets me Monopoly on the Sega Genesis.
Wow.
Do, 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 do.
Hey, this is pretty nice condition though for a cardboard box. Got a manual and everything.
$10.
No, $10. Oh my gosh. For a board game that like everybody has like 5 copies of.
Wait, I owed you $10 anyway, so
true,
here we go, there we go.
Okay.
Alright.
I guess I'm thankful, I guess. I really don't know what to say. I'm kind of shocked.
And then on the other hand, Tyler, being the nice guy he is, you know, tells me, oh, you need to play this game. And he had been telling me this for about a month or two now. And I knew I needed to. And I was thinking about getting it for a while, and I just didn't, you know, see it on eBay or at any of the game stores for the price I wanted to pay for it. And so Tyler comes up and he's like, I wanted to give you this. He pulls out Sonic Adventure 2 Battle for the GameCube. And he had been talking to me about this game for a long time now. And I'm glad he did get it for me, because I've really wanted to try it out, actually. It did come out on the Dreamcast, and I don't know what the differences are between this version and the original Dreamcast version. I'm assuming they added the multiplayer aspects because, oh well, it's only 2-player. So I don't know. I really wanted to try it though. Can't wait to finally play it, and thank you, Tyler, so much. I think you paid $15 for this, and I really appreciate it.
So the first place I went to had a game that I had already researched and I was kind of interested in. Let's just put it this way. It's a 3D Tetris puzzle, and that game is called Tetrisphere. Got it for $5 over at the game exchange table. Fairly good condition, not in box. It's about the average price for this game. So yeah, it was a good find. It was the first game I found, so I enjoyed that. Thank God I didn't walk out of there with nothing. All right. So the next vendor I went to was this very were these very nice people. Don't exactly know who they were. Still kind of don't know. Anyways, I got three games from them bundled together. One was a failed, broken gift from Kyle. And at one point in time it was. And another one I'd heard about, and another one I hadn't. So the one I hadn't heard about was Rampage World Tour. However, I did already know about Rampage on the NES, because Kyle already has that. It's marked for $8. I'll tell you what I got, because I got it all in a bundle. Then I got Diddy Kong Racing, which was that one-time failed gift that Kyle tried to get me. It was broken on eBay. But anyways, I'm glad to have it.
Thanks
now.
For the reminder.
I'm glad to have it now. And then there's Jet Force Gemini, which I have also heard some pretty good things about. So I will be trying that out soon. That was marked for $5. Diddy Kong Racing was marked for $9. Grand total of all these games would have been $22. I got them discounted for $20. So that was kind of nice. Got three cool N64 titles. In fact, everything I got here was N64 related. Just going to put that out there now. Then I went over to another vendor, not sure what his name was exactly, but he had something that caught my eye, and something that you people who have been asking me to do a OGR on, not going to say which game it was, have been asking me for, and this gave me the capability to do it, and I knew I probably wasn't going to find it anywhere else, at least that easily, in as good of condition. However, it is missing the yellow foam piece. But anyways, so over at another table, these two were supposed to cost $10, got bundled for $7. So the first thing I got was a licensed Rumble Pack for the N64. And the other thing I got was a microphone for the N64. And with this microphone, those of you who have been asking me to do an OGR on this game might already know which game that is. If you can remember that far back. So anyways, yeah, I got these both bundled together for $7. I figured it's a good thing to have in my collection. Gonna probably need it for an OGR in the future. So yeah, that was nice to pick up.
So finally, I get to this one booth, and they just have a ton of games. It's just like, they have tons of games for tons of different systems, and I just kept seeing things that I wanted to get. So I'm gonna start with the Genesis and kind of go chronologically up, I guess. Really, that's just the way they're kind of laid out. I these are the way I think I picked them out in order. So when I saw this, I knew I had to get it. It's a game that I've really been wanting to play on the Genesis. I did actually, this was one of the few games, it's funny, this is one of the few games I actually emulated when I was trying out emulators. And don't emulate, by the way, but I really wanted to play it that bad, so I went ahead and tried it for about an hour, and I loved every second of it. So I have been looking for this game probably since the first PRGE I went to, which was about 3 years ago, and I finally got it. I told myself I was going to wait to get it boxed, but I just needed to get it at some point, and I finally found it for a decent price, and I was willing to pay it. And that is Zombies Ate My Neighbors for the Genesis. And this game is so fantastic. I haven't played it since I bought it, but from that hour that I emulated it and from other videos on YouTube, this is such a great game. It's just so fun. It's like a top-down shooter, and I don't know, there's not really a whole lot to say other than it's just really well made and it's really fun. So I'm finally happy. I can say I added it to my collection. Another one that I've actually been wanting to get on the, if I don't drop it, is Haunting, starring Poltergeist. And this is one that's a little less well known. I'm sure most of you have heard of Zombies Ain't My Neighbors. But this one, I was looking through a top 100 Genesis games list, and this one popped up, and it looked pretty interesting. And it's always been kind of like around that $10 to $20 range. So I never really jumped on it because I felt that was like a bit too much for a Genesis game that I didn't quite know if I wanted. But I saw it here. Same booth. I knew I wanted to bundle some stuff together because I didn't really feel like 18 for Zombies Ate My Neighbors was in my comfort zone. I know that's not a bad price at all, but I felt like I wanted to kind of bundle and save a little bit. So I went ahead and picked this one up just because I've been interested in trying it out. And I mean, that's really the story with the rest of these. You know, I've wanted to try these games, and they were just there, and I thought, hey, the more I can put together, the more I can save. So the next one here is South Park Rally for the Sega Dreamcast. And this is basically, to be honest guys, it's just like a Mario Kart clone with the South Park characters. I've heard it's not amazing by any means, and you know, it's not super great or anything. The graphics aren't that good. I think there's a couple glitches and stuff that I've seen, but I want to try it just for the novelty of it, and I went ahead and picked it up. The next one I got here is another game I've been wanting to try, and I didn't really do my research when it came to this. I knew I wanted to play one of the games in this series at some point, so I went ahead and decided to start with the first one, even though I think I read that it's, you know, not the best one. I think it's up there, but I don't think it's as good as some of the later ones. But I went ahead and got Twisted Metal for the PS1. And this one, I've been just dying to play. It looks insanely fun. It just looks awesome. You just crash into other cars, and it's like basically like an arena deathmatch where you're driving cars and trucks into one another. So I've been wanting to try it. $8. I'm sure most of you have heard it already, and I bet a lot of you have good things to say about it. So I went ahead and finally decided to pick it up. These last two games are GameCube games. This one, I honestly, when I heard Tyler say that this was a good game, I was kind of like, what? That? No. No. But I went ahead and took his word for it, and I got Barnyard on the GameCube. I have not played it yet. I am solely going off Tyler's word for this game. I have no idea if it's good or not. Tyler said it's fun, so I just said, hey, why not? For $3, you know, even if it's a terrible game, it's another one to add to the collection. So I do want to try this out and tell Tyler what I think about it. But yeah, kind of an interesting one there. And then the last thing I got at this booth was Rave Race Blue Storm. And I'm sure you guys have played at least one of the Wave Race games. Probably the one on the N64, and I think I've heard that this one isn't nearly as good, but I have always wanted to try it. It's another GameCube game to add to my fairly small GameCube collection right now. So yeah, that's what I got at that booth. This altogether, I think totaled, like, what they had marked was 57, and I was able to talk them down to 50. I originally had said 45, and they kind of laughed, and you know, I think part of it was just kind of like the mix of games. Like, I had, you know, Barnyard here, and then I had South Park Rally. They were probably like, what the heck? You know, this kid has weird taste in games. But yeah, got that for $50. All games I've kind of been interested in or curious about or have really wanted, like Zombies Ate My Neighbors. So I thought that was good. That was the first batch of stuff I bought, and I'm really glad I did.
So after a while, we all got hungry, so we decided to stop video game shopping because most of us were drywalled. Andrew, no. But he bought SNES stuff with all his money.
So the other guys in the group, cough, cough, not me. Although, yeah, my legs were hurting a little bit. They were complaining at about 11:45, somewhere around there. And they're like, oh, I'm hungry. And to be honest, I was a little bit hungry too, but they were being kind of annoying. So after their constant begging, we finally decided, okay, we're going to go to Burgerville.
We walked to Burgerville, and only our free will and empty stomachs kept us going. And once we got there, we ordered all of our food.
Andrew decides that he's going to film us eating.
We're all sitting there sipping on our milkshakes. And then Andrew decides to take out his camera and rip off a gaming channel. We're not going to say which channel that is.
Retro Liberty.
We're sitting there eating. And to be honest, we're kind of at that point where we've been talking to each other for a couple hours, so we're pretty quiet.
I love that guy.
We don't say a whole lot, and he just keeps running the camera, and we just kind of like want the cameras to be off, and he's just like doing like funny tricks with the camera, like eating and pretending it that like it's a point of view shot, and we're just like, okay, come on, Andrew, turn off the camera. We're just trying to eat here.
Filming us eating at a Burgerville. I'm never going to forget about that. Because that, my friends, why would you do that? I don't know. Why did he do that? Wanted to rip off a gaming channel.
The next booth I went to just really stood out because of the sheer amount of boxed NES games this guy had. He had this table set up. And I think he was selling a couple loose NES games, but the majority of his table was just taken over by a ton of boxed NES games. And I just looked and I was like, wow, that's a really impressive NES box collection. And so I felt like I had to buy something from the guy just because of how cool it was. And this is a game that stood out to me that I didn't already have. And even though it was a bit pricey, I was willing to pay for it considering it's a classic and I've always wanted to try it. And I think this is where Kirby got his start. So I got Kirby's Adventure complete in box, super mint, in this nice box protector that the guy had on all the games, which is super awesome. The guy took tons of care with all this stuff. And this thing is really mint. Like, it's really mint. So I'm really glad. You know, $30, not the most amazing deal or anything, but I felt like the guy was really nice, and I've been wanting to try this game, so 30 was definitely not out of the question, and I felt like, you know, I'll do it.
This was a game that I'd been waiting to get for a very long time. Mind you, I didn't get it, like, below average price. It was, like, what, $5 below average price because they weren't willing to go down any further. But I was happy to get it all the same. Smash Bros. Is possibly the greatest contribution to my N64 library to now, really. I mean, this is by far probably going to be the best game in my entire collection for a while, until I can probably get a copy of, like, Conker's Bad Fur Day, and in this case, we're talking about rarity and stuff like that, but also in how fun the game is. So anyways, yeah, I got this for 40, it's labeled for 45. Unfortunately, I didn't know that Tyler and Terry had, I forgot that they had 4 mint copies of this exact same game because of a trade they had just done, so that was kind of depressing, but I'm so glad to have the game. I think that the price was kind of fair. I mean, it's a little sun damaged, but not too bad. It was worth it. Gonna enjoy that game. The next game, the game that I was talking to you guys about, being one of those games that you guys wanted me to review as an ORG. Man, I don't even... It's not an org. It's an... Wait. It's an ogre. It's an ogre. Oh my god, it's an ogre.
I've been calling them ogres for a while now.
Oh my god, obscure game reviews could totally be called ogres. Wow. I am, like, really stupid. So anyways, you guys wanted me to play a game called Hey You Pikachu for an ogre. And, ogre. Over at a Game Trader. Not Retro Game Trader, just Game Trader. Over at Game Trader, they had one in pretty good condition for $5. So I decided to pick that one up. Expect that in OGR whenever I have time to do stuff and I actually want to do an OGR.
Finally, like usual, you know, I've always got to buy stuff from Tyler and Terry because they're just like the best guys. I consider Tyler a friend. Heck, I consider Terry a friend. So, you know, I feel like every time we go to one of these expos, I owe it to them and to myself to buy stuff from their booth. So, and plus they give me really good deals. They give both of us really good deals. Well, they give all our friends really good deals. So it's definitely worth it to always stop by and check and see what they have. There wasn't a whole ton of stuff that was really popping out at me, but these three I have really wanted to play. And so the first one I picked up was Popeye. And this one, you know, they had it marked at $11. And I've always wanted to play this game. I love the Popeye cartoon. And you know, I've heard this is a pretty good game, so I went ahead and just picked it up. Really, I only wanted to spend about 50 there just because I had already spent 80, and there are other things that I'm trying to save up for at the moment, so I didn't want to spend all my money at this expo. So at this point, I was pretty stiff on saying, you know, I'm only going to buy 50. So there were a couple games that I did have to pass on after I was trying to make the deal. But these other two, I'm really glad I got because they are some more expensive games and I'm really glad to add them to my collection. And the first one here is Balloon Fight, and I'm sure most of you guys have heard of this and I've just always wanted to play it, so I went ahead and picked it up and they had it marked for 20. So it is a more expensive game, but I was willing to pay for it because I really wanted to try it out. And the last one here I had never heard of. So this was kind of an interesting one to pick up. It was a bit of a gamble, but Tyler and Terry both said that the game was pretty fun. And so I went ahead, you know, I'm willing to take their word for it. If they say a game's good, I'm probably going to like it. So I went ahead and got Cool World on the NES. And I've heard this one's a bit more uncommon. I had never heard of it before getting there. And they had this one marked for 33. And for me, I think 33 was a bit high in my opinion, because I had never heard of the game, but I was just so fascinated by it because, again, it had never been talked about. I had never heard about this game ever before, so I felt like I had to get it. I felt like I owed it to myself to get it. So I went ahead, got all three of those. This was marked, let's see, 33, 20, 10, $63. $63. And I was like, I was making the deal with Terry and I said, you know, could you please go 50? And he said, you know what, Kyle? Yeah, sure. And I just got to say to Terry and Tyler, thank you so much, because, you know, there are, like I said, other things I'm trying to save up for. And it was just really cool of them to give me such a great deal.
So you may be thinking, what did I take away? Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. Wow. So you may be asking yourself, what new experiences did I take out of this year's PRGE? To be honest, I took three new things out of this. One, talking to new people that I never met before. Two, adding new video games to my collection that I've wanted for at least a year and a half now. And three, a Burgerville trip to remember. Can I pick up a mag with my mouth?
So guys, what I took away from this expo was, okay, the first thing, the biggest thing that I think happened, in my opinion, at the expo was that we got to finally meet Pete Doerr. He wasn't able to make it down to the PRGE for the past 2 years that Derek and I had gone. And so when I heard that he was going to be there this year, I knew that I had to talk to him. If I didn't talk to any other YouTuber, I knew I had to talk to him because he had not been there. So we see him. We're walking around, and we finally see him. And we're like, oh my gosh, it's Pete Doerr. He's actually here. And we walk up to him, and he is just the nicest guy. We were talking to him for quite a while. We talked to him for longer than any other YouTuber that we talked to. And he was just so genuinely nice. You know, he didn't act like, oh great, there's another group of kids that wants to talk to me. Or, you know, he wasn't trying to like speed the conversation up or anything. He just let us talk, and it was really cool to talk to him, and I felt really honored to actually be able to finally meet the person that really got me into collecting retro video games in the first place. So that, to me, was easily the best part of going to that expo. And of course, getting new games, seeing friends. I'm just glad that we got to go and be a part of such a great community of people. And just going to that reminded me how great the YouTube gaming community is. And I want to thank you guys for watching our videos. I want to thank all the other retro YouTubers that make this part of YouTube so great. And that's really what I took out of it this year.